when you say Bismillah, you're actually intending to do something. So either you're going to read, you say Bismillah Aqra'u, Bismillah Akulu, Bismillah Akhruju. Whatever you're going to do comes after Bismillah. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says it comes after Bismillah. Why? Seeking the blessing of Allah, because the name of Allah precedes that. So Lafzul Jalala Allah precedes whatever you're going to do, seeking the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And secondly, he says, limiting the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because all blessing is only from Allah. So you say Bismillah is not just said in vain. You don't say Bismillah, then you eat, that's it. No, there's a great meaning behind it. Bismillah. And they loosely translate it as I begin, or in the name of Allah. But a correct and a better translation would be, I begin, if you're going to begin to do something, I begin in the name of Allah, seeking His blessing only, because of limitation, only. Seeking His blessing only, because only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you can get the full blessing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Lafzul Jalala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest of all of His names, because all other names follow it. Look, after he said Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman from Allah's name. Ar-Rahim from Allah's name. But Allahul Jalala is the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the name of Allah which all other names follow. And it is the greatest name. Ismul A'zam. And likewise, it is preceded with, it begins with Alif Lam. And it is the only name that if you call upon it, and if you call upon Allah, it is the only name where the Alif Lam does not drop. All other names, like Ar-Rahman, when you call upon Allah, you say, Ya Rahman. You don't say, Ya Ar-Rahman. It is the only name the Alif Lam does not drop, as the scholars mentioned. So here, Lafzul Jalala is the greatest name. And what does it mean? Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, Allahu, يعني, Dhul Uluhiyya, the one who deserves to be worshipped. This is what it means. So if you know the meaning of Allah, you know who you are. If the meaning of Allah means the one who deserves to be worshipped, dhul uluhiyya, then you know who you are. You are a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahman ala wazn fa'lan, which means vast mercy, because fa'lan signifies vastness, yani mubalagha. Sighat al-mubalagha is vast. So Ar-Rahman, because both the Muslim and the non-Muslim and the creation, all of creation, they all benefit from Ar-Rahman. From food, from drink, from existence, because He's Ar-Rahman. Allama al-Qur'an, allama al-insan, khalaqa al-insan, allamahu al-bayan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He taught insan, He said here, not just Muslims. He taught all of mankind. He sent them messengers. He sent them books. And for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be worshipped alone. So Ar-Rahman ala wazn fa'lan, which basically signifies vastness. That His mercy is Muslim as well as non-Muslim. They get the mercy of what? Of life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. So He gave everybody life. When they were without life. Did they give Him anything before that? Nothing. Did you give Allah anything before that? Nothing. He gave you life without you giving Him anything before that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is Ar-Rahman. And He gave the kafir life. If this dunya was worth a wing of a mosquito, Allah would not give the kuffar to drink water. Just drink. So in this life is not even worth that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He's Ar-Rahman. He gave the... He gives without anyone giving Him before that. Ar-Rahim is specifically for the believers. Ala wazn al-fa'il. Ala wazn fa'il in the Arabic language, which basically signifies deliverance of the action. In this case, mercy. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers the mercy to who? To the believers. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. So for the believers, this is وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِ الرَّحِيمَ. Allah is Rahim and Allah is Rahman. Of course He's Ar-Rahman and Rahim. He's the one, when you are not even realizing, He's taking care of your affairs. of your risk. وَفِي سَمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوْعَدُونَ Your provisions, your sustenance, your food, your drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking care of all of that. He's taking care of your badan. You don't know that your kidneys are working. You don't even feel it, subhanallah. Your kidney, your liver, your heart. All of that is working by the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you wake up in the morning from the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gave you life after the brother of death, sleep. It may be one day you won't wake up. And maybe that you can't even reach the salah. It's the fadl of Allah that you reach the masjid. The blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that when the imam says, Hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah, what do you say? You say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Why? Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, because you are seeking isti'ana from Allah to reach the prayer. You are seeking isti'ana from Allah, help from Allah to reach the salah. Because la hawla in Arabic language means there is no movement. Wala quwwata, there is no power. Illa billah. So you can't even blink. You can't even breathe. You can't even, your heart can't even beat. You can't even walk. You can't do anything without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help. That's why we say, La hawla wa la quwwata. All the power belongs to Allah. He is the Malik al-Muluk. He is al-Jabbar, the compeller. He is al-Malik, the king. And he's the Malik, the owner. Al-Quddus, the source of peace. Al-Quddus al-Mu'minu. You want protection? Then it's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want security, is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's the Muhaymin. Everything is in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Mu'min, al-Muhaymin, al-Aziz. He's the Almighty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Aziz, al-Jabbar, the compeller. Everything is under his control, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's al-Malik, al-Quddus, al-Salam, al-Mu'min, al-Muhaymin, al-Aziz, al-Jabbar, al-Mutakabbir. He's the one who has all pride. All pride goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If anyone tries to compete with Allah in his pride, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts him in the hellfire. Because pride, he says, is my cloak. Pride is my cloak. Rida'i. So if anyone tries to compete with that, he will put him in the hellfire. Even if it's a grain of pride. We don't compete with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for he's the greatest. He is al-Akbar. When we stand up in the salah, we say, Allahu Akbar, fi'lan, Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest. The greatest. We have not even seen a portion of his creation. And one of the scholars in Medina, Sheikh Abdul Razzaq, he mentioned this as a small example. And it's also mentioned in the books of Aqidah and some which we read before, that some people, you know, what we have seen is like when you look through a keyhole. That's all we have seen. We have not seen much of Allah's creation. When you look through a keyhole, how much can you see? And another example he gave was an example of if you only saw a chicken's head, مثلاً, that's the only thing that you could see, the chicken's head. So when someone says to you, and you're blind, the only thing that you were able to see was a chicken's head for a second, and you're blind, Allah forbid. And then after that, somebody tells you about different aspects, like the sun, the moon. You say, what is its relation to the chicken's head? So that's the only thing you can relate to. Likewise, look at the vastness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. We can see very little. The oceans and what is in them. The heavens, we haven't seen all of the heavens. The stars, the millions of galaxies and Milky Ways. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Akbar Allah. We are very small. But sometimes we like to feel proud sometimes. And this is not a good trait. Sometimes you feel, some people like to feel proud and arrogant. And this is not a good trait. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا Don't go in the land full of pride. إِنَّكَ لَن تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضَ وَلَن تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا You did not penetrate the land, the earth, nor did you reach the mountains in height. That's in Surah Al-Isra. In Surah Al-Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ Allah doesn't like the proud, arrogant, boastful person. And Shaykh Rabbi ibn Hadi, hafidhahullah, in explanation of Surah Al-Luqman, he said, there's two evil traits Allah hates, and I hate it as well. And they are arrogance and lying. Two evil traits, that you're a liar and an arrogant person. What is arrogance? Al-kibr. The Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Al-kibru batru al-haq wa ghamtu an-nas. that the kibr is to batr al-haq, to hide the truth. You don't like the people to know that you actually, you know, made mistakes. You don't like the people to know that you hide, and even to the extent that it's oppression of others, and you still want to hide it. You don't want to be truthful. You don't want to be honest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, "Kunu ma'as sadiqeen." And the second one is ghamtun nas. Even if the people are truthful, they want to come back, they want to repent, you don't even want to accept that from them, because you're proud and arrogant. SubhanAllah. One evil trait to have. And arrogance is not good. Wallahi, dhamim, khuluqun dhamim, an evil trait. The Messenger ﷺ was not arrogant. He used to lie on the floor and the mat would be on his back. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 1 month would pass and he not even fire will be kindled in his house. 1 month. 3 days he did not eat on a roll, sha'ir bread. Bread. 3 days in a row he did not eat. That's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger of Allah. So he begins by saying, أَبْدَأُ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مُسْتَعِينًا. I begin in with the name of Allah, مُسْتَعِينًا. لَا شَكْ وَلَا رَيْبْ. مُسْتَعِينًا, seeking the help of Allah. You can't do anything without Allah's help. رَاضٍ بِهِ مُدَبِّرًا مُعِينًا. Being pleased with him. Are you pleased with Allah as your Lord? This is a dua Rasulullah s.a.w. would say, رَضَيْتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ نَبِيًّا. He would say this in the morning. He would say it in the evening. رَاضٍ بِهِ. And Allah is pleased for Islam as your religion. الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Allah is pleased for you to be a Muslim. So why we should be shy? Why should we be shy to be a Muslim? To go out in the street and be, alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim. First and foremost, I'm a Muslim, and you should be happy to be a Muslim. To be pleased, as Allah is my Lord. Who can harm you if Allah is protecting you? Who can harm you? No one can harm you. رَضٍ بِهِ مُدَبِّرًا. Allah is the planner, Allah. أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمَرُ. To him belongs the creation and the amr, the affair. مُدَبِّرًا, he is the planner. Plans all of our affairs. مُعِينًا, and he is the helper. نِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى وَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرُ. As Allah says, what a blessed mawla, helper he is, and a blessed one to give victory. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ كَمَا هَدَانَا. And all praise is due to Allah, just as he has guided us. نعم الحمد لله كما هدانا. And hidayat is two types. Hidayat al-tawfiq and hidayat al-irshad al-bayan. As Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, Hafidh Al-Hakami, and other mashayikh, they all explain these two types of hidayah. Sheikh Mu'taymin rahmullah in his explanation of Fatiha, where they mentioned it's two types of hidayah. Hidayat al-tawfiq belongs only to Allah. And hidayat al-irshad wal-bayan, this is for the messengers, the people who follow the messengers, calling the people, the du'at, calling people to Islam. Allah gives them that ability, يعني, for the knowledge that He has given them, He gives them the hidayat al-bayan, of clarification and irshad, to propagate. And when we say ihdina sirat al-mustaqim in Fatiha, which hidayah are we asking? Is it the tawfiq or the irshad? Does anyone know? Which of the hidayah are we asking? Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says you're asking two. Because you would like hidayat al-bayan, somebody to come and show you the way. And also, you'd like tawfiq from Allah. So you're asking both of them. As for the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he did not have the ability to give tawfiq, you know, to open the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya Muhammad, لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء. Oh Muhammad, you can't guide those whom you will, but Allah guides whom He wills. But in the other verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى الصِّرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And you guide to the straight path. So what does that mean? هِدَيْتِ الْبَيَانُ وَالْإِرْشَادِ. It's all clarified in the Quran. إِلَى سَبِيلِ الْحَقِّ وَاشْتَبَانَ. Allah told, we want to be guided to سَبِيل الْحَقِّ. What is سَبِيل الْحَقِّ? سَبِيل الْحَقِّ is singular, is not plural. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, singular. Say, this is my path. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Call to Allah, إخلاص. إخلاص. عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ. For knowledge. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I and whoever follows me, and subhanallah, I am not from the mushrikeen, the polytheists. So here, sabili is one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ نَعْمْ مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. Don't be from the like the mushriks, the polytheists, those who split up the religions and became groups. كُلُّ حِزْبٍ لَدَيْنَ فَرَقٍ. Each group happy what it has. And in the other verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا. Hadith ibn Mas'ud, when he drew a line on the ground, and he drew other lines to the right and to the left, and each one is shaitan calling to it. Shorter lines. But the straight path, it may seem longer, but it is the only path which is accepted by Allah. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he recite? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي singular. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا. What does مُسْتَقِيم mean? Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says, it means it's flat and it is straight. It's the quickest way to get to your destination, flat and straight. If it was hilly, it would take longer. If it was crooked, it would take longer. So everyone who complains about Tawheed and Sunnah, oh, you always talk about Tawheed and this takes too long, this path. This is the flattest path and the straightest path, Tawheed and Sunnah. Nuh alayhi salam, 950 years. So why should we not call to this blessed path and be patient upon it? And if we get the victory, alhamdulillah, our security, alhamdulillah. If we didn't, at least we died upon this path of Tawheed and Sunnah. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. Ah, plural. Don't follow other paths. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونِ. What piety, taqwa? This is, don't follow other misguided paths. The paths of bid'ah, the path of khurafat, superstition, the path of sins and disobedience. Don't follow those other paths. And worst is the bid'ah, the innovation. Because as Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah said, bid'ah is more pleasing to Iblis than sin. Because a man may repent from his sin, but not necessarily from his bid'ah. So bid'ah is evil. Bid'ah starts small. As Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said in Majmu' al-Fatawa, it starts like a hand span, then becomes an arm's length, then becomes a mile. Look at the bid'ah of the Khawarij. How did it start? It starts small. Bid'ah of the Khawarij starts small. First, it starts with what? They were in the halaqa, Sunan al-Darimi, Hadith Sunan, the author of Sunan al-Darimi. Ibn Mas'ud, they were in a halaqa, in the masjid, not even in the market, in the best place to be. But what were they doing? Say subhanallah with a date stone or with a stone. They would say subhanallah, and everybody in unison in congregation would say subhanallah. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah. Tasbih, tahmid, takbir, tahleel. They would do all this. On the outset, it looks like a good deed on the outset, but it's not a good deed. Why? Because good in the Sharia is what the Messenger said is good. And that which he has not brought in ibadah, it is rejected. Hadith Aisha radiallahu anha. Man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahu radd. Whoever does an action which we have not brought, which is not according to our affair, it will be rejected. Hadith in Sahih Muslim. And in Sahih Bukhari, man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fahu radd. Whoever introduces into our affairs what we have not brought, it will be rejected. And also many narrations, Hadith Sunan al-Majah, Muslim Imam Ahmad, Sunan Abi Dawood, the Hadith of Irbad ibn Sariyah. وعدنا رسول الله بموعظة بليغة وجلت منها القلوب وفاضت منها العيون قلنا يا رسول الله كأن موعظة مودع فأوصينا قال أوصيكم بتقوى الله وسمع الطاعة وإن تأمر عليكم عبد حبشي فإن من يعش منكم من بعد فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي عضوا عليها بالنواجذ bite onto the sunnah with the molar teeth. فإن نعم. Why? Because after you, you will see many differences. فإن من يعيش منكم من بعد فسيختلاف عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي عضوا عليه من وجه وإياكم محدثات الأمور فإن كل محدث بدعة. And be warned of the newly invented matters, for every newly invented matter is innovation. This hadith, sahih. Hadith of Irbad ibn Sariya, radiallahu anhu. So this path, which path is it? Everybody is saying we are upon the right path. Are they upon Tawheed and Sunnah? Are they upon Ikhlas and Ittiba'? Ittiba' of who? Of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. According to whose understanding? According to understanding of the Sahaba. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Surah An-Nisa, verse 105. This is the sabil, the path of Sirat Mustaqim. What is that path? The understanding of the believers. Who are they? The Sahaba radiallahu anhu. Quran, Sunnah, and Ijma' of Sahaba. These are the masadir of Islam. Quran, Sunnah, and Ijma'. What the Sahaba united upon is Deen. And the highest form of Ijma' is what? The highest form of Ijma' the Khulafa' al-Rashidin. Because he said, Sunnati Sunnati al-Khulafa' al-Rashidin. The highest form of Ijma'. If they unite. Taba'an, if all the Sahaba unite. But primarily the four and the two. The Prophet said to the woman who asked, he says, اقتدوا بالذين من بعد يعني بأبي بكر وعمر. So this is again from the highest form of Ijma' if they unite. Abu Bakr and Umar رضي الله عنهما and Khulafa al-Rashidin, if they unite, then that's Deen. That's considered to be Deen. Many of the misguided groups today, they're not upon this Sabil al-Haq. Because they call to their newly invented group, as Sheikh Ubaid always calls them, the Jama'at al-Haditha, the newly invented groups. They are not, you can trace them back maybe only 50 years, 60 years, like Jama'at Tabligh, this century. There was no Jama'at Tabligh at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no Sahaba, no Tabi'in, no Tabi Tabi'in. No. Why? Because what did they concentrate on? Fadha'il A'mal. Is this the manhaj of the Anbiya, Fadha'il A'mal, first and foremost? No. First and foremost, the manhaj of the Anbiya is what? Usul. Calling the people to Tawheed. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ الرَّسُولَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاشْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. As for Fadha'il A'mal, this is good, inshallah, jazakallah khair. Teach the people how you need to have good manners. This is something good. But this is taba'an. This is follows the obligations. What is the obligation? Is at-tawheed. To worship Allah alone. Keep away from shirk in all of its evil types. This is the asal of the da'wah to tawheed. The da'wah of the anbiya, of all the prophets. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ بَلِ اللَّهَ فَاعْبُدُكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. Allah said that to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you were to commit shirk, you will make your deeds. Say to them that it has been revealed to you and those before you that if you were to commit shirk, your deeds will become null and void. Batil, khalas. And that's in Surah Al-Zumar. And in Surah Al-Ma'idah, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions Surah Al-An'am. He mentions 18 prophets and messengers. And right at the end he says, وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. If they were to commit shirk, their deeds would become null and void. And in the last part of Surah Al-Imran, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in the last part of Surah Al-Ma'idah, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ, to Isa alayhi salam, did you say to the people to worship me? أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ, أنت قلت للناس ها الآية نعم أنت قلت للناس ها نعم اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانك ما قلت إلا ما أمرتني به أن اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم وإن قلته فقد علمته تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت علام الغيوب أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني أي نعم جاءت الآن أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله. Did you say to the people to worship me and your mother and my mother, your mother besides Allah? Because now we have the Catholics, they call upon Mary and they have the Mary dua. And the general Christians, they all call upon Jesus. Yesterday or 2 days ago, I had Jehovah's Witness knock on my house. Knock at the house, old lady, I said to her, you say that Jesus is God? She says, yes. No, she says he's the son of God. I says, okay, if he's the son of God, that means he has to have attributes of God. She says, yes. So I said, okay, if he has attributes of God, so therefore God is the all living, as we know, al-hayy al-qayyum, the all living. That means he must be also the all living. She goes, what do you mean? I said, meaning that he doesn't die. She said, yes. I said, but you just said that he's the son of God and he has attributes of God, but you believe that he died on the cross. So how could that be? Allah, he didn't know what to say. She goes, anyway, I have to go. And you believe this, believe. They know, ya akhi. They know that this is batil. And Isa alayhi salatu salam will be free from them on Yawm al-Qiyamah. He'll be free from them. Because Allah will question him. And he will say to him, did you say to the people to worship me and your mother? He says, ma qult. He says, subhanak. First word he said, subhanak. How is Allah from imperfection? Ma qultu illa ma amartani bihi. I did not say except that which you have ordered me with. An i'budullaha rabbi wa rabbakum. And even he said, and if I said it, you would have known. You know what I conceal, I do not know what you conceal. Innaka anta allamul ghuyub. You are the allam. The sighat al-mubalagha of alim. Not just the all-knowing, the one who knows all of this. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of the unseen. So Sirat al-Mustaqim is not the way of Jama'at Tabliq. Sirat al-Mustaqim is not the way of Jama'at Tabliq. Who don't call to Tawheed. Who don't call to the usul, the fundamentals of this deen. Na'am. وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ مَا يَكُونُ إِنَّ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِحَقٍّ. He says, Subhanak, it's not befitting for me to say that which I have no right to say. Allahu Akbar. إِن كُنْتُ قُلْتُهُ فَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ. And if I had said it, you would have known. تَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِي وَلَا أَعْلَمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِكَ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ إِلَّا مَا أَمَرْتَنِي بِهِ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ. I did not say to them except that you, what you have ordered me with, to worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ. And I was a witness over them for the time that I was there amongst them. I was a witness, shaheed, amongst them. Just like all the Anbiya, shuhada. Shuhada, they were witnesses to their people. So here, Sirat al-Mustaqim, ila sabili al-haqqi. Wajtabana. Allah chose us. Wajtabana, yani wakhtarana. He chose us to be upon this blessed path. Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, just last week, before we came from Medina, he said, he gave a nice kalima to some brothers who came from England. He said to them, Allah, look at the blessing Allah has given us. To recognize, first of all, to be Muslim. Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum. He gave you Islam, which is the only religion accepted by Allah. Inna al-deena inda Allah al-Islam. No other religion. Like nowadays you have Qardawi and other than them, they say that all these religions are religions samawiyya, yani from the sky, yani from Allah. Judaism, Christianity, since when did they become from Allah? Inna al-deena inda Allah al-Islam. And the other verse, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ إِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ. Whoever chooses a religion other than Islam, it will not be accepted from him. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. In the hereafter, he will be from the losers. So no other religion is going to be accepted by Allah. And the Messenger said, except Islam. The Messenger himself said, whoever hears of me, whether he is a Jew or Christian, and he doesn't follow my way, then he's in the fire. He's in the hellfire. No other religion is accepted by Allah. Because that is all shirk. That is all newly invented, yani away from the way of the Anbiya, of the Prophets. The last of the Prophet is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alas, he came, and there's not allowed for anyone else to go other than follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So look at these misguided groups from Ikhwan al-Muslimin who say that we are all brothers. Qardawi says this. The Jews, the Christians, they are our brothers. How could it be? How could it be when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَإِنْ تَابُوا وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ. In the other verse, فَخَلُّوا سَبِيلَهُمْ. They are your brothers in faith when? Anyway, when they establish the prayer and they give the charity. They're your brothers. My brothers, the Jews and the Christian brothers. It doesn't mean that you harm them. La. Rather, you invite them to Islam. لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم. Allah does not forbid you from those who don't drive you out of your houses nor fight you in your religion, that you be good to them. تقسطوا. What is قسط? قسط is justice, that you be just to them. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ. Your Lord orders with القسط. Be just. Be kind to them. And just to them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the ulama as having qist. As he said, شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنُّهُ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّهُ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ يعني بِالْعَدْلِ. That they are upright upon justice. So سبيل الحق is not the way of Ikhwan Muslim. Who have the motto of Hassan al-Banna, تَعَاوَنُوا فِيمَا تَفَقْنَا عَلَيْهُ نُعْذِرُ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضَ فِيمَا اخْتَلَفْنَا فِيهِ. We cooperate in that which we agree upon, and those things we don't agree upon, we can excuse each other. Even shirk, even bid'ah, there's no excuse for this. There is the deen of Allah. قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة. That is it. We follow that path. As you bring your own opinion, أظنُ أو أفكر كذا وكذا. لا, that's not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has to be upon قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة. كما قال ابن القيم رحمه الله العلم قال الله قال رسوله قال الصحابة ليس بالتمويه بل علم نصبك لخلاف سفاهة بين الرسول وبين رأي فلان أو فقيه. It's foolishness, سفاهة he called it, to compare Rasulullah's awesome statement with even scholar statement, with even a scholar statement. You can't. This is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this is not the way of Ikhwan Muslimin, nor is it the way of Jama'at Tabligh, nor is it the way of the Rafidha, who curse the companions when Allah says radiallahu anhum wa radu an. Nor is it the way of the political activists. Day and night they're shouting for Khilafah when Allah already told them how to get Khilafah. How? Surah Nur verse 55. How you get it? Tawheed. And keep away from shirk. Allah will give it to you as a gift. Surah Nur verse 55. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا يعبدونني لا يشركون. And Shaykh Rabi Hafidh adds a further benefit. The verse before it, the verse after it, talks about obeying Allah and His Messenger. And talks about establishing the Salah and prayer discipline. You want victory just like that? Easy. MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. How does a woman give birth? Doesn't she go through 9 months of labor? Doesn't she go through 9 months of hardship? And then labor. How do you get the fruits from the harvest? You have to plant the seed. You have to water it. You have to wait for the sun to come out. You want things to be quickly. That's why Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah used to say a beautiful poem, a nice statement. تَرْجُ النَّجَاةَ وَلَمْ تَسْلُكْ مَسَالِكَهَا إِنَّ السَّفِينَةَ لَا تَجْرِي عَلْ الْيَبَسِ. You want success, but you don't tread its path. Indeed, the ship does not sail through dry land. The ship needs water to sail. If there's no water, how is it going to sail? Likewise, you want victory, day and night you jump up and down like the socialists whenever there's a problem. And then in the end, what is the benefit? You did nothing. Nor did you rectify the society, nor yourself. Why? Because you did not establish that which is important upon yourself. So, oh, Hizb al-Tahriri, you are not free. Like you claim to be the party of freedom, you are not free. Because you are a prisoner. To ignorance. Because if you were upon freedom, then you would accept Tawheed and you accept the Sunnah of Rasulullah. How could it be? You want success, you want victory, you can't even establish the Salah. Iqamatu Salah, you can't even establish that. Shaykh Muhammad Amman Al Jami, rahimahullah, in his explanation of Surah Thalatha, he says, these people, it's like somebody goes to the market and he calls people to Salah. So everybody comes, the one upon Janaba, the one with no wudu, the one who needs to do ghusl, the woman in the menses, everybody comes to do Salah. Yakfi, Salah is accepted? No accept. Why? Because you need Tahara first. So what is this? You want victory, you want to establish Islamic state, you want to establish, you don't even do Tahara first. لابد من طهارة. طهر قلبك من الشرك والبدع والخرافاء. All of that. How do you do that? Be sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Learn التوحيد in these three categories. توحيد الربوبية والوهية أسماء الصفات. Follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ترجو النجاة ولم تسلك مسالكها إن السفينة لا تجري على اليبس. The safina does not go through dry land. And so this is the sabil al-haq. And who is upon that sabil al-haq? At the head of it are the ulama. In this time, who are they? The likes of Shaykh ibn Baz rahimullah, and Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimullah, and Shaykh al-Albani rahimullah. We say that with conviction. With conviction. If you ask all these misguided groups, who are the ulama? They start stuttering. We have no stutter in what we say. Because this is with yaqeen. Because the Messenger said in a hadith, which is in Sunan Abi Dawood, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْعَثُ عَلَى رَأْسِ الْقَرْنِ مَنْ يُجَدِّدُ لِلْأُمَّ أُمُورَ دِينِهَا. Allah will raise at the head of the century who revived the deen as a whole. Who revived the deen at the 1400 years? Who? Hassan al-Banna did not even reach the head of the century or the beginning of the century. Not Kafir calendar, not even Islamic calendar. So how could he be from the Hassan al-Banna meaning the Ikhwani? How can he be from the Mujaddidun? But if you look at the likes of Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimullah, Shaykh al-Albani rahimullah, Shaykh ibn Baz rahimullah, at the head of the century they were in their 60s. And what does the hadith say? Yujaddidu lil umma umura deeniha. They will revive for the ummah the deen. What is the deen? Hadith Jibreel. Ja'akum liyu'allimakum deenakum. What was the deen there? Mal Islam, mal Iman, mal Ihsan. This is the deen. Who revived Iman? Six beliefs. Who? These ulama. Who revived Islam? Five pillars. These ulama. Who revived? Whereas many of the political activists, mashallah, they can speak maybe a lot about politics. And whose politics? It's not even the politics of Sharia. Siyas Sharia. They'll talk about politics of what? Of Karl Marx. Machiavellian politics. They want to give you politics of قال الله قال رسول الله قال الصحابة. No. Put it in its place. Of a السمع والطاعة. يعني في المعروف. They will not know how to speak Sharia politics. They will give you the politics of the streets. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So سبيل الحق is the way of أهل السنة والجماعة. The way of the Salafiyun. أهل الأثر. They are the one upon the Sirat al-Mustaqim. They are the سبيل الحق. And at the end of them are the ulama, the likes of Sheikh Saif Fawzan in this time, and the likes of Sheikh Abdul Masih Abad, and Sheikh Rabi' bin Hadi, and the likes of Sheikh Ubaid al-Jabri, and Sheikh Saleh al-Sahimi, and Sheikh Ali Nasir Faqih, and Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, and Sheikh Zayd bin Hadi, and Sheikh al-Haydan, Hafidhahumullah, jami'an. These are the likes of the ulama today. And before them we mentioned the three, and Sheikh Muqbil, rahimahullah, bin Hadi, al-Wadi. Sheikh Muqbil rahimahullah, when he went to Yemen, he said, I did not look forward to go there يعني, in the beginning because I knew the big task at hand. So he said, I had to really, يعني, I didn't have much, not much money, but he had, alhamdulillah, he had Tawheed and Sunnah. And he opened the whole country, Allahu Akbar, with what? With not much money, with Tawheed and Sunnah. And some students, يعني, they ended up being bought by jam'iyat and so on. And they went astray. You see, money is fitna. Money is fitna. It's a trial. How many times Sheikh Muqbil rahimahullah talk about that? Money is a trial. Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi says, مَا لَا يَمِيلُ مَيْلًا. Money comes from the word to deviate in the Arabic language. مَا لَا يَمِيلُ مَيْلًا. How many people in the beginning they started with Tawheed Sunnah, Ikhlas. And afterwards, Jam'iyyat Ihya Turah come, and other Jam'iyyat al-Bir come, and this Jam'iyyat come, one by one they get bought. In the end, MashaAllah Tabarakallah, it is the pocket they're looking for. Not the Qala Allah, Qala Rasulullah, Qala Sahaba. Because of Maal. And then they start making principles, Qawaid, against what? Against Ahlul Sunnah. Not for Salaf. And they call it in the name of Salaf. Qawaid al-Salafiyya, wa ma'adri aish. نسأل الله السلامة. For what? For miserable price. فويل الذين يكتبون الكتاب بأيديهم ثم يقولون هذا من عند الله فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. This is the way of the Jews and the Christians who used to write with their own hands, you know, adding to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or adding. This is their way. But as for Ahlul Sunnah, la. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen is going to be protected. إِنَّ نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّ لَهُ حَافِظُونَ. Allah revealed the dhikr, the Quran, and we're going to protect it. There's no need. If you are for deviating, Allah will expose you one day. And if you are plain, Allah will expose you. Nobody gets away. أين تذهبون؟ أين تذهبون؟ Where are you going to go? Where are you going to go, hide? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الإنسان يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقي. Oh mankind, you're going to go back to your Lord to meet Him. So where can you hide? You get money, you buy property, buy land, buy this, buy that, mashallah, in the name of Islam. Allah, as Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, the army is better than you, because you use in Islam for your pocket. You use in Islam to cheat the people. You use in Islam and changing it, the qawa'id of Ahl al-Sunnah, saying that Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he used to mix with the Shia, the people who used to speak against the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. He used to mix with them. Did Imam Ahmad do that? When Imam Ahmad rahimahullah was known for his adherence to Tawheed and Sunnah, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah did not compromise that, cooperate with the innovators. That was not Imam Ahmad. That was the Dahir when he came to his house. He knocked, he didn't lay him in his house. He didn't lay him in his house. Why? Because he heard that somebody spoke about him. He didn't lay him in his house. And not only that, even those scholars who in the time of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, they were not strong or they did not stand firm in the fitna of Khalq al-Qur'an, say that the Qur'an is created, he didn't want to talk to them. When Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah came to him to apologize or to seek, you know, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he didn't want to speak to him. And then what did Yahya ibn Ma'in rahimahullah say? He said, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ. Except the one who is forced and his heart is full of iman. He said, how can you use this? Imam Ahmad Rahman said, how do you use this? When this verse was revealed, it was revealed regarding Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu, when he's already been tortured. They said to him, revile the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was being tortured. Afterwards, he accepted what they said to him, and then he felt so much remorse. He came to the Messenger and told him what he said. He said, how did you find your heart? كيف وجدت قلبك? He said, مطمئن بالإيمان. He said, full of iman. He said, وإن عادوا فعد. And when they ask, come back again, then say the same to them. يعني, then repeat. He didn't intend that with his tongue. Takfir is now, if they saw that, they'll call him a kafir. And Hizb al-Tahrir, they'll call him a kafir. They don't know kufr has levels. And also they don't know they have to make iqamat al-hujjah for specific ruling upon an individual. They don't have that in their deen. They misquote Shaykh Salam Taymiyyah rahmahullah, but they don't know Shaykh Salam Taymiyyah rahmahullah mentions about the general ruling of takfir and the specific ruling of takfir in volume 12, page 200. Have you got Majmu' al-Fatawa here? Do you have Majmu' al-Fatawa? Of Shaykh Salam Taymiyyah rahmahullah? عندكم? موجودة? لو تعطيني المجلد الثاني عشر. Volume 12. Either 200 or 500. I'll get it for you. ها? لا مجموع فتاوى شيخ سلام تيمية. ما عندكم? طيب. ما في مشكلة. Anyway, just so that you can go back. Volume 12, page 200 or 500. One of those. You see there, and I'm more inclined to 200. 200 and 201. What does he say? He talks about specific ruling upon making takfir. Al-takfir don't have that. You see? They call it the general ruling. Of course, general ruling, we all believe that. Whoever calls upon other than Allah is a mushrik. whoever does sujood of Allah is Muslim. Like in specific ruling, Fulan ibn Fulan, you call him, no, you have to establish the hujjah. Maybe he didn't intend that. Maybe the knowledge didn't reach him. القصد العلم لا بد منه انتفاء الموانع والشروط لا بد من الشروط. So this is the specific ruling, but the أهل بدع they generalize. That's why Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله says عليك بالتفصيل, be detailed. The Sharia is detailed, be detailed. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says وفصلناه تفصيلا, not something which is general, huh? Detailed. The Sharia is detailed. They come with general verse, cut and paste. This Sharia, la. Keep what you have. We want detailed explanation of the deen. Because Rasul ﷺ did not leave anything out. As Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, he said, تَرَكْنَا رَسُولَ سَلَّمُ وَمَا تَرَكْنَا رَسُولَ سَلَّمُ وَمَا طَائِرُ يُقَلِّبُ جَنَاحَيْهِ فِي الْهَوَىٰ إِلَّا وَأَخْبَرْنَا عَنْهِ. The Prophet left us upon a way. Even the bird flapping its wings in the sky, he told us about it. Even the bird flapping its wings, he told us about it. Delicious. Rasulullah didn't leave anything out. And whoever brings into this religion that which is not brought, is not only that is rejected, but he's actually claiming Rasulullah hasn't deceived the message. As Imam Malik rahimahullah said, whoever brings a bid'ah, it is as if he is saying Rasulullah has deceived, khana risala, he has deceived the message. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. It's a great sin. You bring a bid'ah. So, إلى سبيل الحق is سبيل السلفيون. سبيل أهل الأثر. سبيل أهل السنة والجماعة. That is أهل السنة والجماعة. Not the Sufis who innovate. Dhikr. Saying Allah, Allah, Allah. Did Rasulullah do that? No. So, leave it. Who? إيش هذا؟ أعوذ بالله من ذلك. So, Look at their dhikr. The Prophet already told us how to do dhikr. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, subhanallah, alhamdi, subhanallah, al-azim, la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahu al-mulku, lahu al-hamdu, huwa ala kulli shay'in. Dhikr, he taught us. Some of these Sufis, not only they do bid'ah, they do shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shirk. How do we know that? There's a Naqshbandi here in Manchester. Long time ago, I met this Sufi who said there's my sheikh in Manchester, Naqshbandi. Huh? He knows if you prayed Fajr just by looking at your face. MashaAllah, he knows ilm al-ghayb. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِيحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُ. Allah has the keys of the unseen. What is this jahil? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well said in Surah Al-Luqman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Luqman, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْبِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وما تدري نفس بأي أرض تموت إن الله عليم خبير. Allah is the عليم خبير. He's the one who's all knowing, knows everything. And in the other one, وإنها in Surah Luqman again, وإنها إن تكن مثقال حبة فتكن في صخرة أو في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله إن الله لطيف خبير. Allah is the لطيف. He's the خبير. The one who's able to bring out the most minute details, the minute deed that you do, he will bring it out يوم القيامة. How can you compete with Allah with knowing the unseen? The Burda of Busayri that Hamza Yusuf translated. What does he say there? Again, competing with Allah regarding the unseen. In the Burda of Busayri, it's quoted there as saying that, and you, the Messenger of Allah, what is your knowledge except ilm al-lawhi wal-qalami? The knowledge of the lawh al-mahfuz, the preserved tablets, and the qalam. And the pen. Is that the knowledge of Rasulullah? The knowledge of the preserved tablets and the pen? Yani he knows the ghaib? The ghaib is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these mushrikun, or people of shirk, whether they be the Sufis, some of them who extreme Sufis, who claim to know the unseen, and have so much bid'ah in there, how could they be sabil haqqi? Cannot be sabil haqqi. Alhamdulillah. That's why Hafidh Al-Hakami rahimahullah said, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah kama hadana. Allah, Alhamdulillah. He guided you, Ya Abdullah. He guided you to know Tawheed. He guided you to know Asma'ul Sifat, Allah's beautiful names and attributes. He guided you to recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he deserves to be worshipped. He guided you to keep up your salawat, your prayers. The Prophet said before he passed away, he said, As-salah, as-salah, ma malakat aymanukum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنَ كِتَابًا موقوتا, prescribed time. He guided you to pray on time, Ya Abdullah. He guided you to keep your salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أقيموا الصلاة لدلوك الشمس إلى غسق من الليل قرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. He guided you to pray the Fajr with the angels, they split shift. The angel of the night with the angel of the day. At Fajr and Asr, Allah swore by Al-Fajr, Wal-Fajr wa-layalin ashr, wa-shaf'i wal-watr. He guided you to pray the Asr in Jama'ah, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى. Allah swore by Salat Al-Asr, Wal-Asr, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. He guided you to pray the ibadah to Allah. This is a blessing. There was a man on YouTube, they said to him, he's paralyzed, Muslim. They said to him, what thing you wish for? He said, I wish for one thing and I can't do it. They said, what? He said, I wish I could just do sujood to Allah. Allahu Akbar. Ya Abdullah, Allah has given you khair upon khair. He gave you much. He gave you so much. So value the salah. The salah is great. The salah is your key between you and Allah. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he says, there are two standings in front of Allah. One in this life and one in the hereafter. The one in this life is your salah when you're standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other one in the hereafter is the Yawm al-Qiyamah, where each and every one of us will stand in front of Allah. That's why it's called the day of standing. Yawm al-Qiyamah, Yawm al-Hashr, the day of gathering. Everyone will gather together and stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will come to Allah furada, alone, with their actions, with their deeds. And how will you be, Ya Abdullah? Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says, if your standing is good here, then your standing is good there. And if your standing is bad here, your standing is bad there. It means the standing of salah. So how are you with your salah? How is your salah? Is it 2 minutes? Salaamu alaikum, khalas, let's go on my business. Is it upon ghafla, heedlessness, without thinking, without realizing of what you're saying? How is your ibadah, Ya Abdullah? This is the thing you're going to be questioned about. First and foremost, how's your siyam? How's your sadaqah, zakah? How's your other aspects of worship? Hajj, umrah. You have money, you don't do umrah. You don't do hajj. How are you going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Maybe you will die. Maybe this is going to be your last year you're going to live. What have you done with your life, Ya Abdullah? So thank Allah, alhamdulillah, alhamd. Thanking Allah with your limbs. Making shukr to Allah with your tongue and your heart and your limbs. كَمَا هَدَانَا إِلَى سَبِيلِ الْحَقِّ وَاشْتَبَانَا. This is so great, this line, that Allah guided you to the سَبِيلِ الْحَقِّ. أَحْمَدُهُ سُبْحَانَهُ أَشْكُرُهُ مِنْ مُسَاوِ وَمِنْ مُسَاوِ عَمِلَ أَسْتَغْفِرُهُ. I thank him and I praise him, and from my sins I seek his forgiveness. This is what the Rasulullah did 70 times a day at least, and 100 times a day. We ask Allah subhanahu to protect us and forgive us, and seek his forgiveness from the evil of ourselves and from our evil actions. There was 3 lines. Inshallah, we'll continue afterwards. Wallahu a'lam. Wa sallallahu sallam ala khair khabdillah Muhammad. Wa akhir da'an alhamdulillah bil alamin. Thank you.